With us right now, we are excited to have Mark Wallington in the studio, communications director with UNLV football and tennis. And you've been with the program, Mark, since we were saying 1993.
Yeah, 3 decades almost come up. You know, we did the big 50-year anniversary of the football team, and then this football stadium, Sambo Stadium, turned 50 years old. Boy, I've been here for a lot of that.
Oh my goodness! You were saying you left college, and then all of a sudden you got a job, and you've been with it ever since. It's amazing.
Came here for an internship on University of Florida after getting my master's, and the UNLV just hired someone from the University of Florida as the athletic director. He brought me over for an internship, and now 27 years later, still here.
That's the best internship ever.
Yeah, about the same pay.
That's what we all say, right?
But you know, this is probably one of the most exciting times in all of your experience at UNLV, having the Raiders coming to town, having a new football complex. I mean, kind of in a nutshell, can you talk about the excitement surrounding the program right now?
You know, it really is amazing, because I tell people there's never been a college program in the country that has had all this happen at once. We're moving into a world-class football stadium, maybe the best in the world. Mm-hmm. Not many colleges can say that. Plus, we just opened a $35 million training center on campus, the Fertitta Football Complex, in the same year. So it's an amazing transformation, and this is the time to take advantage and start turning that program and become a consistent winner. And I think there's a buzz, there's an excitement. The Raiders coming in, and now we've become pro town with the Knights. It's really made the brand of Las Vegas very attractive to young elite athletes, and we just found that out with signing day.
Yeah, and tell us about signing day. I mean, obviously, you've got a new coach, and then all these amazing signings. I was following them all on Twitter. But by the way, all the players were following me back, so I like them already. They know they got to be part of Las Vegas.
Yes, they're buying in. They're buying into our new head coach, Marcus Arroyo, who we just announced in mid-December, and since then he has turned 40 years old. He went out and hired an entire staff of some amazing assistant coaches from big schools, and then didn't sign anyone in December when he could have, and he decided to wait until February 5th, National Signing Day, took a chance. He said he bet on us, and he went out and signed 28 people. It's our biggest class ever. It's the number one class in the Mountain West Conference for the first time, and really one of the best classes, and easily the best recruiting class in school history. We have the highest rated high school kid coming in, and then we have the highest rated transfer coming in. A guy, this 4-star quarterback out of TCU from out of Texas, coming in and hopefully competing right away for us.
Oh my God.
Well, and what do you think it's going to do for conference play in the Mountain West? Because we've seen the Pac-12 has just kind of risen through the ranks and started to be a part of the national conversation. And with the recruiting that you're able to do now, with the facilities that you have, does that help elevate the program and the conference as a whole?
Well, you know, college football, all sports come down to production out of players. So you got to get the players. I mean, coaching obviously matters, but you have to have the players. And that's the difference. Those two buildings that we talked about have transformed us as a destination. Some of the guys, Dana said she was watching them as they agreed to come here and sign their letters to come here. You can tell how good they are by the offers of the other schools.
Right.
You know, and there's a guy, when I said the highest rated high school recruit, he could have gone to LSU. He could have gone to Florida. He could have gone to Alabama. He could have gone to USC. He bought into Marcus Arroyo, and he's a rebel now. And there's a lot of players now that we beat out. There was a kid who Washington State came in on and tried to steal away at the last minute. We held on to him. So we're now beating Pac-12 schools on a lot of kids, and that's the difference. And that's going to be the difference in the results as we move up the standings on the field.
It's exciting. Tell us a little bit about the facility, too, when you talk about the Fertitta Complex. I mean, give people who are listening an idea of what we mean here. I mean, it's incredible, right?
It is incredible. It's a top 10 facility out of the 130 schools that play FBS football. It's a top 10 facility in the country. You know, Oregon's up there, Clemson. But we're in that conversation to put UNLV in the same sentences with those schools. Because of this building, former coach Tony Sanchez, from the day he was hired to the 5 years he was here, he fundraised for that building, made it a reality, raised almost all the money himself. The community bought in, the Fertitta family, a lot of families in town. It was all private money, $35 million, and we just opened it a couple months ago. It's an amazing place. It's got a barbershop.
Oh, wow. That's cool.
It's two stories, 75,000 square feet. Just for football, just for meeting and strength conditioning and athletic training. And there's a pool table and a social area for the locker room's unbelievable with the TVs and the video games. And, you know, that's what kids care about nowadays. Yeah. And now UNLV has an upper hand in that.
So let me ask you this. With all those facilities, with the video games, with the pool table, the barber shop, is there any intention in having those facilities to keep the players at the facility and off of the craziness that can happen on the strip?
You know, it's funny, John Robinson, legendary Hall of Fame coach who was here for 6 years, he always said, parents ask me, well, how do you keep the kids off the strip? Well, they can't afford to be on the strip.
Yeah, true.
And this new facility gives them a day-to-day home to make their own for every practice. 6 days a week, they'll be at the Fertitta Football Complex. One day a week, they'll go and play at Allegiant Stadium. So it's an amazing pairing of facilities at the same time, which is really going to thrust the program.
The caliber. And I'm just curious, can the public come watch the team practice?
You know, Coach Arroyo is still deciding on the schedule for the spring. I do know it starts March 24th, but we're still deciding like where the spring game will even be and what that'll look like. We haven't got into the day-to-day yet in the next fall about whether practices are open or closed. So that's still TBA.
Mm-hmm. And what about when it comes to the games at the Allegiant Stadium? I think you don't want people to confuse, you know, it's not going to be Raiders game prices, right? I mean,
no.
The public's going to be able to afford to go and support the team.
There's a season ticket price as low as $119.
Wow.
To get in there, you know.
Amazing.
And the thing that our athletic director has decided to do, and is very wise, is, you know, it's a 65,000 seat stadium. Well, we don't need 65,000
right.
seats. So we're only selling season tickets on the lower bowl. So we consider the 27,000 lower bowl, that's UNLV stadium. That includes all the amazing suites mm-hmm. and club seats and luxury seating, but that's what we're going to focus on, and we're going to try to sell out that lower bowl at 27,000, and then hopefully there's a big enough demand that we start selling upstairs. But that's our goal, and I think it's going to be attainable. We've done some amazing selling out some club seats already, some of the higher level mm-hmm. luxury, because like you said, the price difference between the Raiders and us, same facility, but we're very low cost compared to them. Desiree Reed Francois, the athletic director of UNLV, said there's a seat for every wallet in Las Vegas.
Oh, I love that.
And,
yeah.
And that's, I mean, obviously that's great for Las Vegas locals, but even tourists who are coming into town on college game day, who want to get in and see the stadium, this is a great way to do it.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, we love our partnership with the Raiders, but they're going to sell out. They're the NFL. For a lot of people to be able to enjoy and experience college football or any kind of football in Allegiant Stadium, they're going to do it through UNLV, and we're love to have them.
Yeah, that it's true. It's such a great way to experience the stadium, support the team, and then, you know, folks coming in to watch the other team, too. You know, that's the great thing, and then they can spend a couple days in Vegas.
and with that facility, the opponents you're going to see an upgrade in opponents as well.
Oh.
You know, I had help with the scheduling, and I get a lot of phone calls now. People are calling us, hey, can we come play UNLV? And we're talking some big names that usually don't even come out west at all. And they want to come play in that. They know that there's some great recruiting to be done here in Las Vegas, so they want to have a presence here while playing in a world-class stadium. We're going to open against Cal. We've never played Cal in football. That's the opening game, August 29th at Allegiant Stadium. That's the big opener for us. And then we have teams like Arizona State, UCLA, Vanderbilt to become the first SEC team to ever come play in Las Vegas. So people are going to see a great schedule when they come out to the stadium as well.
I was just going to ask if there's SEC teams who are starting to express some interest.
We've got a lot of calls.
Uh-huh. Yeah. I imagine.
August 29th, that's going to require at least two tall, cold beers, isn't it?
Oh, without a doubt.
And I love these little helmets. Thanks for the pocket-size helmet set. Can we get these at the website or at the store?
No, those are exclusive.
Exclusive just official?
Totally.
Thank you. I love it. And where do we go buy tickets? UNLV?
UNLVtickets.com online, mm-hmm. if you want to do it online. Or you can call 739-FANS, F-A-N-S, 739-FANS, if you want to talk to a person. Or you can do everything online, just pick your seat and buy it. And, you know, the beautiful thing is during the season, you just pick your seat, print it at home, and then that's your ticket, and you just go right through on your phone, you know, so you never even have to go to the box office.
Everything is so easy now. I really quickly wanted to, because I see your communications for tennis, too.
Yes.
Tennis is becoming huge. Every morning I wake up, I live in a high rise, people are playing tennis. And I have a lot of friends that are on tennis teams, and more so here than when I was back in upstate New York, where I lived for most of my life, moved here 15 years ago. But tennis is becoming really popular. How's that going? How's that program going?
Well, it's funny, because that's another facility. It's the Fertitta Tennis Complex.
Right.
And that was from Mama Fertitta, Vicky Fertitta. She's the one who funded that. Right before I got here, Frank and Vicky Fertitta Tennis Complex. That was the first Fertitta building on campus, and that's for her affinity for tennis. I went to Florida, so I really enjoyed Florida Gator tennis as a student. Mm-hmm. So when I came out here, I was excited to get tennis as one of my sports, so I've had it all the way through. And we've had national champion in singles, national champion in doubles for men. Mm-hmm. We have a 12-time conference champion women's team. They just won, and they won a round in the NCAA last year. So that's also another top 20 facility in the country, the Fertitta. And the men's and women's teams are some of the winningest here at UNLV.
Incredible. Yeah.
It's amazing. And with World Team Tennis now being played out of Las Vegas,
coached
too.
Coached by a former Rebel who won the doubles national, Tim Bleekgren won the national championship at UNLV as a doubles player. Now he's the head coach of that team.
Mm-hmm. So really, if Las Vegas's profile could be lifted any further, I think it's happening right now.
Yeah. What a great year. Listen, Mark Wallington, thanks so much for coming on. It's going to be an exciting year. We look forward to getting out there. I'm actually going to hop on when you were talking about season tickets for $119 starting at. That's a great price.
UNLVtickets.com.
Thanks, Mark.
Thanks, guys.